So, I literally can't believe that I'm saying this for the second time in less than 3 months, but ladies and gentlemen, meet the latest printer from Bamboo Lab, the A1 Mini. I know. But unlike when I had the privilege of introducing the world to the P1S just 9 weeks ago, this time, as you can see and as you cannot hear, there are some real surprises and some head scratchers. But stick around because I've not only had the chance to play around with this printer, but also to pick the brains of the very people who developed it and manufactured it in person at their headquarters in Shenzhen. And in this video, I'm going to explain why this little printer is about to disrupt the entire 3D printing market once again, just like the X1 Carbon did a year or so ago. Let's get after it. We're going to get into the specs and the performance in just a second, and trust me, it's not what you expect. So if you want, you can skip ahead using the chapters below. But first, I want to explain what this printer is, and in order to do that, I need to explain why it exists. Why would Bamboo Lab, who disrupted the entire industry by making one of the first ready-made super solid consumer core XY printers, develop a bed slinger? I actually had a chance to play with this printer before nearly anyone outside of Bamboo Lab even knew it existed, and yet I was still kept in the dark until the very last minute. Literally. I knew I was headed to Bamboo Lab to film a new printer, but like most of the industry, I had absolutely no details. Then, 20 minutes before I was set to arrive, I received a WeChat message from Candice, my rep at Bamboo Lab, with the review sheet and specs, and my heart sunk. It was a Cartesian design, a bed slinger, a cantilever bed slinger. What the f? Why? After all, I, like all of you, know exactly what Bamboo Lab's customer base wants, a larger format version of the X1 Carbon, and that may well come in time. But in my discussions with Bamboo Lab's team, including Dr. Tao himself over lunch, I came to understand that Bamboo Lab isn't targeting their existing customer base of 3D printing enthusiasts with this machine, at least not intentionally. Like Anchormake, Anycubic, and many other brands right now have their sights set on a new demographic, what I like to call the Cricut crowd. Bamboo Lab is trying to do what Cricut did for vinyl cutters and what DJI did for drones. They're trying to make it accessible to the everyday consumer. Children, grandparents, the non-tech savvy. And to do that, they needed to create a product and a price point that is accessible to anyone. By the way, it's at this point that I'll point out and pat myself on the back just a little bit that this is exactly in line with the strategy I described in my first ever video about Bamboo Lab, in which I explained that they would likely follow a similar path to Tesla or Bugatti, using their high-end model to create economies of scale and buzz until they could create their very own Model 3. Now, they haven't followed a completely linear path, of course, as they've responded to market forces by introducing the P1P before the P1S, but make no mistake about it, the A1 Mini is Bamboo Lab's Model 3. It's the model that is going to make 3D printing accessible to everyone, everywhere, and really popularize the hobby. Here's how. Like the Anchormake M5C that I recently played around with on the channel, the A1 Mini is designed to be much easier to use and maintain than some of Bamboo Lab's other printers. First of all, it comes not only fully assembled, except for the AMS and some other small odds and ends, but also its open design actually means that it's dead simple to maintain, which, as I discussed in my M5C video, is still really the biggest hurdle I see between, say, my father-in-law and 3D printing. Second, which again is similar to the M5C, the A1 Mini has been timed to launch alongside Bamboo Labs' own printable file repository, MakerWorld, which is integrated directly into the smartphone app. The idea behind these apps is quite simple. Non-technical users are going to be turned off by needing to download files to their computer, orient and support them in a complicated slicing software, then slice them, send them to the printer. But nearly everyone is comfortable browsing a directory of designs on their smartphone. That's why, in the first of many quite innovative features, the Bamboo Handy app actually allows you to print directly from the app to any Bamboo Lab printer, even if pre-sliced G-code is not provided. You can still choose your selected printer and profile, but there's no need to tinker around with the actual settings or slice the files yourself. Now, this is a major step up from AnchorMake's own app because it allows designers to simply import their files or upload them to MakerWorld as is, and users to just print them. No fuss, no muss. BabelLab also took another page out of the Cricut playbook and now includes one of five mystery boxes with each order. Here, for example, you can see the wireless mouse and the lamp projects, and they include everything you need to do your first two projects, lowering the barrier to actual, functional, and practical 3D printing, and ensuring that the user has everything they need to get hooked on 3D printing right out of the box. But there are three other mystery boxes out there, which I won't reveal so that those of you who actually buy this printer, hopefully using the link in the description, will have a nice little surprise because you actually never know which one of these you're going to get. Plus, and this is honestly a shocker at this price point, there's a camera and an LED, both of which Bamboo Lab informed me will be used not only for time lapses, but for failure detection. Now, I haven't had a chance to play around with any of that yet, but I think it's a very smart feature to include in a printer that aims to take that fear and frustration out of 3D printing. And if all that isn't enough to make this printer appealing to everyone, there's the size. This printer, without the AMS light I'm going to talk about in just a second, takes up as much space as an A4 sheet of paper. So when I say that Bamboo Lab envisions having one of these printers on every desk, that isn't really a stretch as far as actual desk space is concerned. Heck, this printer takes up about half as much space as my inkjet printer, and as I'll cover in a moment, it makes a hell of a lot less noise. And come to think of it, I think it's actually easier to use and maintain as well. Actually, on that note, let's talk about the interface. Unlike the M5C or the Cricut Maker, for example, this printer features a simplified touchscreen interface, which honestly I think is important. Users like to know what's going on, and what's more, it makes basic maintenance functions much easier, as the device can actually give you helpful messages using the AI assistant right on screen. On that note, I'll add that this machine is quite clever. Sure, it does auto bed leveling and resonance compensation and all that out of the box, but it also uses an ingenious trick to provide auditory feedback to the user. You hear these beeps and bops telling you the printer is ready, done, or encountering an error? Yeah, those aren't speakers. They're actually the motors, vibrating at specific frequencies. Genius. Furthermore, the printer arrives pre-squared, pre-tuned, and just about pre-everything. It does, like I said, require about 10 to 15 minutes of setup, but the instructions are incredibly clear. Each screw is labeled and parts are designed in such a way that you literally can't make a mistake. Another nod to the fact that this really is for non-technical people. The first time you boot it up, it will do all sorts of calibrations to ensure quiet, flawless prints. It even performs real-time flow tuning on every single print as you go, using an eddy current sensor and various other tools and sensors in the tool head to measure the speed and odometry of filament, the tension above the extruder, and the pressure under the extruder. Now, all this effectively eliminates clogs, jams, and all the other types of issues that would be too hard for a non-technical user to repair themselves. But what if you do have a nozzle clog, or you just want to replace the nozzle to a different size? There's no way that non-technical users can do that, right? Well, Bamboo actually thought of that as well, and they developed this new quick swap hot end, which requires one clip to remove. One clip. You don't even have to unplug any wires. Just unclip, swap, and clip. From maintenance to setting up the machine the first time, it's all been designed to be so easy that a literal child could do it. As the end user, to get started, you just need to follow the instructions on screen to run some final calibrations and you're off to the races. From unboxing to printing is about 20 minutes or less, and that includes assembling that AMS light. Yeah, you heard that right. So let me now also introduce you to the AMS light, Bamboo's new multi-material system, which is an optional upgrade to the A1 Mini. Like me, you're probably scratching your head. I mean, Bamboo has a perfectly good AMS system on the market already, so why develop a new one? Well, according to their engineering and marketing teams, there are a few reasons. The first is cost. They wanted to make multicolor 3D printing more accessible, in case you couldn't tell by the fact that they put in what I can only imagine was hundreds of hours and a Herculean effort into creating, stocking, assembling, and managing the logistics around these full color swatches so that every single A1 Mini user has a full sampling of every PLA, PETG, and ABS color that Bamboo Lab makes. That's important, not only because it helps people pick the right color for their next project, but also choosing original bamboo filament will lower the complexity and reduce errors for inexperienced users or those who'd prefer to print directly from the Maker World app. That's because, as you probably already know, Bamboo Lab's official filament comes with RFID tags inside, and yes, the AMS Lite can read them and feed that information back into the app so that users never have to worry about printing the wrong filament at the wrong temperature or selecting colors or any of that. Though I will add one other benefit of the design of the AMS Lite is that unlike the standard AMS, it works with cardboard spools, unusually sized spools, or even broken spools with no issues. But wider compatibility, color swatches, and automatic filament recognition are really just the first step towards making multicolor more appealing. The next major hurdle involved bringing the price down, which meant ditching the costly enclosure. And though this machine looks more complicated and intimidating as a result, it's actually designed to be much more reliable, dependable, and foolproof. It can, for example, detect filament tangles and save your print before missing a single layer. It also, due to its open design, requires far less technical savvy if, for example, you need to unclog a piece of filament from the Bowden tubes. It features motorized spool rollers, which feed the filament at the appropriate rate, reducing tension and eliminating any issues with tangles or filament unwinding. It even allows optimization to reduce the amount of purging and purge towers necessary. But what about speed? I mean, after all, as anyone who has an original AMS will tell you, filament changes take a ton of time and turn many users, myself included, off from multicolor 3D printing. Well, here as well, Bamboo Lab has really outdone themselves. You see, because this setup now runs 4 Bowden tubes to the extruder and switches the filament right there, there's no need to pull the filament all the way back and then push it all the way forward for every switch. And that means that this new AMS Lite is much, much faster at swapping filaments. Even though the printer itself may not be quite as fast, at least not with the default tuning as its Core XY bigger brothers, you will find if you slice the same multicolor file for the A1 Mini that it will actually print faster, more than 10% faster in most cases due to the time saved in filament swaps. In fact, while you might not think so by looking at it, faster is a common theme with the A1 Mini. And we'll get into that in just a second. But first, let's talk for a second about the format of the A1 Mini. It's open. And as I mentioned before, that's a deliberate choice. It lowers costs and it makes maintenance much easier. But it also means that while printing, your filament is exposed to the elements. Now that's probably not the end of the world if you're mostly printing PLA, but what if you want to print PETG or ASA? Or what if, like many people, you take years to go through a single spool of PLA and it's going to be sitting out for quite some time? Enter Sunlu, who fortunately just launched the crowdfunding campaign for their new S4 filament dryer. It allows you to dry 4 rolls of filament, the same 4 rolls that you would use with your A1 Mini, with an easy-to-use set of presets for PLA, PETG, TPU, PC, and anything else that you might want to print. Best of all, it's the most efficient and powerful dryer Sunlu has ever created, allowing you to quickly dry your filament so that you can get back to high-speed printing. Plus, it even allows you to print directly from the dryer. I actually tested this out with the A1 Mini and the AMS Lite to see how it would behave if the motorized filament spool holders were empty, and it actually just worked fine. I took the Bowden tubes here and connected them under here, and everything just works. So if you wanted to do some multicolor PETG prints, you could do it right out of here, which is pretty awesome. Right now, Sunlu is offering the first 300 units at a staggeringly low $79.99, but the price will be going up to $129 after October 13th, or once all 300 units are sold. So to check out the new S4 filament dryer and support the sponsors who make videos like this one possible, visit the link in the description. All right, now let's get back to the A1 Mini. As you may or may not realize, Dr. Tao and the Bamboo Lab executive team built their careers developing patented technology at DJI, specifically technology for using motors to stabilize motion in robotic devices. So it should come at no surprise that Bamboo Lab changed the game with their sophisticated input shaping and resonance compensation technology back in 2022. Well, guess what? They've done it again. And I was shocked to find out that this machine, in many instances, will actually print faster than the X1 Carbon or P1P. Yes, you heard that right. Whereas the X1 Carbon, with its larger print head and bigger masses to move around, can print a 17-minute benchy, Bamboo Lab has actually optimized a speed benchy to print on this thing in a respectable 14 minutes. It does this by not only having smaller masses and sophisticated vibration compensation, but also by being built with incredibly sturdy components, such as all metal rails and linear bearings, which of course reduce the need for maintenance long-term. They also make this little bugger fast. Check out these print time comparisons between the A1 Mini and the X1 Carbon, which I'll remind you costs over 2 times as much without multicolor. But that's not all. Because Bamboo Lab's founding team employs some of the world's foremost experts on the whole motor resonance frequency thing, the A1 Mini is also whisper quiet, like the quietest 3D printer I've ever seen. As if you can tell by the fact that I've been running 2 of them with filament switches under my boom microphone this entire time. It achieves this using a new technological development that, as far as I know, is exclusive to Bamboo Lab. Literally running a noise cancellation measurement during setup and then canceling out the noisy vibration frequencies, in addition to the ones that would cause ghosting on your print, in the same way that noise canceling headphones do. It's insane. Once again, it's clear to me that this machine was really designed to sit comfortably on, say, your kid's small desk in their bedroom, quietly working away while they do their homework or even sleep. Yes, it's literally that quiet. All this is well and good, but what do I really think about this printer? After all, like I said, it's really not marketed at someone like me, a seasoned and tech-savvy 3D printing enthusiast who wants to customize my printers. And the same might be true of you. And look, I definitely don't think it's perfect. When Dr. Tao asked me for an honest opinion, I explained to him that, in my opinion, the design of the AMS system with the Bowden tubes swinging all over the place is going to be off-putting or intimidating to users in a way that an enclosed, beautiful system just isn't. While $500 or less for a multicolor 3D printing setup is an unheard of bargain to those of us already in the hobby, it's still quite a big investment for someone who isn't sure if they'll like it or not. I also still don't love the fact that there's no solution out of the box to collect all the poop. But look, I'm honestly just nitpicking and trying to find cons to try and balance this review out. As I think you can probably tell, this printer has already become my #1 new recommendation for beginners with a budget of more than $300 who don't mind the closed nature of Bamboo's ecosystem. But what about existing 3D printing enthusiasts? Can I still recommend it for all of you? Honestly, yes. Sure, the 180mm³ build volume is going to limit what you can print in a world where many projects out there are designed with an Ender or Prusa build volume in mind. And yet people who own the Prusa Mini, which has the exact same build volume by the way, or even the smaller Voron 0.2, really love those machines and they print plenty of decorative and practical prints on them all day long. And if you consider that this printer, fully built with faster performance, including the AMS light multi-material system, is roughly the same price as a Prusa Mini or a Cybor Voron 0.2 kit, I mean, which one would you choose? Don't get me wrong, I love my Voron 0.2s and I love the project element of building a printer from a bucket of parts, but I think it's going to be a pretty hard sell to get anyone who just wants a great printer to pay $450 to $600, then spend 40 to 50 hours building the machine just to end up with similar or even slower performance and only one color at a time. Is the Bamboo Lab A1 Mini marketed towards beginners? Yes. but it still packs the performance, easy maintenance, reliability, and advanced features that you would expect from a next generation Bamboo Lab printer. And quite frankly, I really hope to see some of these ingenious features make their way back into the successors to the X1 Carbon, P1P, and P1S. So unless you really need a larger build volume or an enclosed printer to print things like ABS, I can't see why you wouldn't pick one of these up. But hey, that's just my opinion. Let me know in the comments below what all of you think. By the way, thanks again to Bamboo Lab for sending me not one, but two of these machines to play around with, including a clear one so I could get those awesome B-roll shots, and giving me the opportunity to see and film them before anyone else. And of course, thank you to my Patreon supporters who get exclusive behind-the-scenes info about what's coming down the pipeline before anyone else. That's all for this one, but I'll see all of you on the next multicolor layer.